Well, according to the CDC's most recent numbers, vaping is related to lung injury and deaths in more than 10 different states. October is National Lung Awareness Month.
So our Rosemarie Beltz sat down with a Lexington Medical Lung Therapist to discuss some of the chemicals that they believe could be connected to some of these cases.
I think that it's a problem for sure. I think that we need to find out what is in these products and what's doing this damage. And I think we need to not use these products until we understand, you know, what's causing the issue.
The CDC is confirming there are now over 800 lung injury cases relating to people with a history of e-cigarette use or vaping and a dozen deaths. Buffy Chapman is a registered respiratory therapist with Lexington Medical Center. She says despite some confusion dividing the medical community, one cause could be linked to the chemical diacetyl. Diacetyl is known to cause bronchiolitis obliterans, a serious and irreversible lung disease sometimes called popcorn lung. Over a decade ago, workers in a microwave popcorn factory got sick from breathing in diacetyl, the buttery flavored chemical in food like popcorn. The flavoring was linked to deaths and hundreds of lung injuries, and the manufacturer removed diacetyl from its products. No single product or substance has been linked to all lung injury in these cases, but the American Lung Association attributes diacetyl found in some e-cigarette flavorings.
Inhale this chemical during that process, and the chemical scars the small airways and causes this phenomenon. And the same chemical has been identified in many e-cigarettes, and we've seen the same kind of thing happen where the diacetyl has damaged those airways. And
the CDC found young airways could be at a greater risk. Over 60% of patients are 18 to 34 years old. So if you use e-cigarettes, these are common signs of lung damage. Wheezing that is not related to other health conditions such as bronchitis or asthma, shortness of breath or difficulty breathing, unexplained exhaustion, or coughing up blood or mucus. The CDC recommends kids and young adults not use e-cigarettes or vaping products, and lung therapists have a warning for adults too.
Consider quitting. You just don't want to be the one that it turns out to, you know, you don't know when it's going to affect you, when you're going to buy a product that's going to have something in it that will harm you.
Gotcha. Rosemarie Beltz, News 19, WLTX.
Wow.
Diacetyl. I hadn't even heard of that before today, but certainly makes you think twice about also making air pop popcorn at home or microwave popcorn at home all the time.
And I mean, the bottom line is she said, consider quitting.
Yeah. Try not to do it.
Try not to do it, which is easy for us to say. We don't smoke. I can only imagine how difficult it must be to give up something that you're addicted to. But, you know, the studies are not lying. The proof is there.
Mm-hmm. And we are going to continue to bring you the latest information every day as we get it.